No mass reopening of schools till 30th November, graded opening to continue. Sisodia lauds school as 5 students crack IIT 22 qualify NEET. Rajasthan schools may open from November 2 for classes 10 to 12. Cabinet nod to open schools and colleges, state gets 3 new municipal corporations. Maharashtra Education Department to develop 300 model schools, none from Mumbai make the cut. Puducherry proposes 10% quota for government school students in medical courses. Samrala government school shuts for a week after lecturer tests positive. Keeping girls in school scene worth billions to developing nations like India could boost GDP by 10% over next decade. Karnataka schools continue online classes despite holidays. Indian Child Poverty Charity offers free school meals in England. Good afternoon and a warm welcome. You're watching Education News Network, where we get you the latest developments in education at the top of this hour. This is Sanya reporting from ENN, and the daily stories are: No mass reopening of educational institutions till 30th November, but states and union territories will continue to enjoy the flexibility to open schools, colleges in a graded manner and on a case-to-case basis in consultations with educational institutes management. In a fresh directive to the states, the Union Home Ministry Tuesday said that its order dated 30th September shall remain in vogue till 30th November. Deputy Chief Minister Manish Sisodia Tuesday visited the Rajkia Pratibha Vikas Vidyalaya, Paschim Vihar, to congratulate his teachers and principal, as 5 students from the school have been selected in different branches of the Indian Institute of Technology. 22 students from school had also qualified NEET. During his interaction, Sisodia said if 5 students can go to IITs and 22 clear NEET from a single Delhi government school, then other schools can achieve this feat too. Rajasthan schools may open from November 2 for classes 10 to 12. Schools in Rajasthan that have been closed for the last 7 months in the wake of the COVID-19 pandemic outbreak may finally start from November 2, at least for classes 10 to 12, confirmed officials. 3 days back, the State Education Department sent a ready proposal to the state government for opening schools for the senior classes November 2 onwards. The Himachal Pradesh Cabinet on Tuesday decided to upgrade the municipal councils of Mandi, Solan and Palampur to municipal corporations by inclusions of adjoining areas. It also approved the resumption of regular classes in colleges and in schools from classes 9 to 12, according to a press release by the state government. The State Education Department will develop 300 Zilla Parishad schools in the state as model schools as a part of its initiative to improve the quality of learning in state schools. On Monday, the department released a list of schools which will be developed as model schools. From the neighbouring region, 8 Zilla Parishad schools from Palghar and 3 from Thane are part of the list. Puducherry has decided to introduce a 10% internal reservation in MBBS courses for students of government schools in the Union Territory who have cleared the NEET this year, Chief Minister V. Narayan Swamy said on Tuesday. After a cabinet meeting, he told reporters that his government has decided to introduce the quota through an order, and the file relating to this has been sent to Lieutenant Governor Kiran Bedi for approval. Government Senior Secondary School for Boys Samrala has been closed for a week after a lecturer tested positive for COVID-19 on Tuesday. The lecturer had been sent into home isolation and the health department has started the procedure to trace all the people who came in contact with him recently. The lecturer, along with 44 other faculty members of the school, had undergone COVID-19 tests last Friday. After he tested positive, all faculty members have been asked to go for a re-examination. Making sure all girls are finishing secondary education by 2030 could boost the gross domestic product of developing countries by 10% on average over the next decade, a report said on Tuesday. Every $1 spent on girls' rights and education would generate a $2.8 return, equivalent to billions of dollars in extra GDP, according to the study. Despite a three-week midterm holiday declared for all state-run schools in Karnataka by the Education Department, several institutions continue to hold online classes. Interestingly, the government order is not clear with regard to conducting online classes. However, verbally, the cancellation of class applies to both online and offline classes. Tushar Girinath, in charge, Principal Secretary, Department of Primary and Secondary Education, had told TNIE earlier. A charity that feeds millions of poor children in India had joined the drive to end holiday hunger in England and distributed its first meals from a new kitchen in Watford. Hot vegetarian dishes cooked for less than £2 each using a model developed to feed the hungry in cities such as Mumbai and Ahmedabad were dispatched to a school in North London on Tuesday amid growing pressure on the government to reverse its decision not to fund free school meals this half term. Thank you for watching Education News Network. For more such videos, log on to our website www.denn.com and do not forget to like, share, comment and subscribe. Signing off, Sanya.